with Smith Board Strength and Conditioning. Today we got another video. Just wanted to kind of vlog my last powerlifting meet. Now this is my fourth competition in powerlifting overall, my second with the USAPL, which is a drug tested federation. This last one was down at Juggernaut Training Systems down in Laguna Niguel, which is Chad Wesley Smith's gym. It was really cool seeing Chad and other world champions like Marisa Inda down there, other big time lifters. Max Aida was down there kind of helping out with the meet. So it's cool to see some big names out there and get some other people, like-minded athletes just trying to crush some big weights. So my last meet, I didn't tell very many people about this, but I actually sustained an injury, and I believe it happened on my last deadlift, which is the one I was like, oh yeah, you know, I finally did it, good job. But I believe that I tore my rotator cuff. Now it wasn't a full thickness tear, but it definitely impaired some stuff for this next meet, and I'd already had been signed up for it. So I figured I would use this as an opportunity, not only for myself, but kind of for others to show that, you know, you can train under injury and make the necessary changes, if you know, to still be able to perform. Now, fortunately for me, the only thing that was consistently painful was bench press. Bench press was really hard. I had to play around with form a lot in order to see what I needed for myself in order to not have as much pain. Deadlifts were the other thing that was kind of painful, especially when they started getting a little heavy. So the ways I modified that were, on certain days that were a little heavier, I would use lifting straps to kind of take some of the grip out to avoid any potential traction. And then I used Mark Bell's slingshot in order to help with the bench press, especially pressing from getting out of the hole. And that allowed me to train, and I ultimately had no pain. Now, going into this meet, I had three main goals. One, I want to go 9 for 9. I want to make all my attempts. And my second one was I want to hit 501 on the platform. I don't know why, but 501 has evaded me this entire time, all four meets. I had it at two meets ago. I had 496 on my second attempt, and I was feeling really froggy, so I jumped to 523 and missed it. But I still don't have a 500-pound deadlift on the platform, which is something I've just been dying over. My third goal, the most important one, is not get hurt. So I hope this video, just to kind of give you guys a little glimpse at my lifts for the day. And I'm filming this after the fact, so this is my kind of bougie intro, just to kind of give you guys a little feedback. So we're gonna go a little time backwards, and then we'll come forward and I'll give a little recap. So we'll see you on the other side.
Down from Mr. Woman, all the winds and the steps and the calling, we rode to a woman's side. For she was a secret treasure, she was his shame and his bliss. And a chain and a keep are nothing compared to a woman's kiss. For hands of gold are always cold, but a woman's hands are warm. For hands of gold are always cold, but a woman's hands are warm. For hands of gold are always cold, but a woman's hands are warm. For hands of gold are always cold, but a woman's hands are warm.
Winter's coming.
For hands hands of gold are always cold, but a woman's hands are warm. For hands of gold are always cold, but a woman's hands are warm. For hands of gold are always cold, but a woman's hands are warm. For hands of gold are always cold, but a woman's hands are warm.
Winter is coming.
So, as you can see, I failed twice. Some weird things happened this meet, things that I've never happened before. Squats on my second attempt went out at like, I think it was 4:30. I got called for depth, which I've never been called for before. I don't know if I was just nervous or what, but I came up high. All three judges did not. They were like, yeah, dude, way high. I talked to actually Max Aida on the way out. And he's like, yo, bro, your butt was way high, not even close. So rather than trying to push it and push the PR, since I already failed one of my goals, was to get Max, you know, to get all nine lifts, since I already knew at that point I was gonna go 8 for 9, I retook 4:30 and I just buried it. I felt like my butt was touching my calves, I was so low. So retook that, got 4:30, gained a little momentum. Went into bench, took some very conservative approaches. It felt awesome. There was absolutely no pain. Now, first lift attempt. I didn't ask for a lift off, and I thought it was just assumed that if you're doing bench press, you usually get a lift off. So if there's like that awkward lull period, normally get a lift off just because it's easier that way. But since it's so light and I trained by myself, I just unracked it, killed it myself, no problem. Second attempt, if you guys noticed, my wrist wraps were missing. So at this particular meet, usually they have some kind of indicator of like when you go up next, and everything was handwritten. And I had my music in and didn't realize it was like my time to go. And I was trying to like quickly put on my wrist wraps and said, nope, screw it, we're taking them off. So ditched the wrist wraps, got on top of the platform, had a lift off this time, benched it, killed it, no problem. Third attempt went smooth, no problem. So I ended with like 275 on the day for bench press, which is, or I'm sorry, 265, which is like normally my opener, but I had no pain and my idea was just to stay conservative. That's a pretty healthy number for me, which I hadn't even tried in training at all, and didn't hurt my shoulder at all coming into the deadlift. Opened with 463, smoked that, went to 485, smoked that. 501, I smoked it up to like halfway up and I could not lock it out. Don't know what was going on. Obviously super, super frustrated, but overall, I didn't get hurt. I wasn't able to train as much as I wanted to, which is absolutely no excuse. I'm not trying to say, oh, poor me, I was hurt. But yeah, that was something I wanted. So definitely next time, that's gonna be the big goal, hit that 500 pound deadlift, switch some things up, get myself healthy. But I hope you guys enjoyed a little day in the life of another powerlifting meet. If you guys like this type of thing, the vlogging, different events and stuff like that, let me know. And we'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.